OMG. Sit back, relax, and sip your tea. We keep you company.
Hi.
Is everyone here?
Hi, hello.
Hi.
Hi, guys.
Good morning.
Not guys. Hello. Good morning. That's such a YouTube thing. Hi, guys, and welcome back to my channel.
Have I even told you about hi, guys? It's not even a YouTube thing. It's not, as in, just keep going.
Forget about they.
Tiny bro, eh?
Him, her.
Who is your bro?
Forget about
if you don't they, get it, you don't get
him, her. Anyway, hello, how are you? Welcome to our channel.
I just got that. Are you looking for trouble with this girl?
No. Okay. People like to be good. Anyway, let's not go there. That's another
thing. How are you guys doing?
Oh, good.
How are you? She's just spamming you people. Don't mind that. How are you people doing? And our subscribers, thank you very much. New subscribers, you're welcome. Old ones, you're welcome. Before we start today, do I have a question? Is it that should we scrap the
story time
with film?
Y'all don't seem to be feeling that too much. Like, I just thought it would be. We thought it would be nice, like you know.
And it's a lot of efforts I put into it. It's actually stressful.
Yeah.
Because to get her is this one we are doing is stressful, but that is like times three stressful. So
yeah.
When we now do it now, and, like this last one, there was just no engagement at all.
Yeah.
And it's discouraging.
It is discouraging. So I think that maybe.
So should we just scrap it and just be doing our Mondays and Fridays talk and games?
Let us know,
Let us know. Cool.
So
today, what are we talking about?
Your nails.
Jeez. It's punk.
You need to cut them nails.
Punk.
What was your plan to talk about today?
You just jumped into the episode. I like that. You trust me so much that I got this.
No, it's not just about that. Because I thought you had something in mind. I may have something in mind as well.
I just asked you.
But that last one was my one, so I just think you should go first.
See. Escape plan. She just came on camera. Just that we should just be talking. There's nothing in your mind. There's nothing in my mind, Susha. So let's just.
There's something in your mind. Should we go then?
Okay, so let's talk about. Let's talk about this thing you made me debate about the last time.
Oh gosh.
On a show, and the debate was: is it proper for a married woman to buy properties in her own name?
Can I ask a question? Why does it have to be married woman? Shouldn't it be a question of, is it proper for a married individual, whether they're man or woman, to buy property in their own name?
Men, basically, like the question came as a result of a lot of women.
Mm-hmm.
There's the expectation that, yeah, whatever the man does is for us, but I have the right to do some things by myself.
Of course,
so that's where it is coming from.
And it's fair, okay.
So that's where it's coming from that.
But also I'm saying that there's also a thing of, you know, as a woman, you're not allowed to do this. But if it's a man, it's for the family.
No.
So why can't a woman? Because what you just said is that the man, whatever the you're saying that you're what you're talking from is from like a traditional perspective in terms of what the man is doing is for the family,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yeah, yeah.
But what about what's the woman doing? She's doing it for herself, not for the family. Because if a man buys,
don't feminize this thing. Don't keep it as simple as it is.
Babe, I'm just asking a question because.
Because now you're asking that, is the woman not allowed to do something for herself?
No, because my thing is, my problem is the structure of that question. Is that, okay, should a woman buy a house on their own, in their own name? Whereas it should be a question of...
So why don't you wait unless you can do, should a man buy a house on their own?
No,
it's just for the context of...
I understand, but
it's not coming from any... It's not like, men are already... faithful, why are women running? That's not the point.
What I said. I don't think you understand what I'm saying.
I get what you're saying now is, okay, it's already assumed that whatever the man does is doing for the family.
Mm-hmm.
And
so why can't that be the same assumption for the woman? So
because
why?
It's coming from what people are saying. It's coming from a couple of gathered thoughts, gathered questions, questioning people around, conversations. That was where you got it from. Do you understand?
Right.
Like, and it's been a conversation over time.
Yes,
do you understand?
Course.
Like, mm-hmm. And it comes from the fact that, oh, women, secure yourself, because you don't understand, the man's family might come for you, or the man might go and cheat with another person. So
and
buy
also,
your property.
Yeah.
Do you understand?
So again, it kind of supports what I'm saying, because, okay, the conversation stems from women that have...
From other women.
Yeah, exactly. Women that have, you know, and the women that have experienced, you know, when their partner has passed, that they, you know, everything has been in the man's name, right? Do you understand? So that's where it stems from. Everything has been in the man's name. It hasn't been a thing of being, and that's a traditional thing that is known, that a man buys a house, but in his name. It's rarely ever in him and his wife's name.
No.
That's what happens, babe.
No. It's not coming from everything is in the man's name. It's coming from families that don't give a damn about whatever. And
yes.
They just hold, like, okay, you don't kill our, go, yeah, leave yet. It comes a lot from that.
So it's not,
a lot of men, like, naturally, a lot of men, like, are protective.
Of course.
Do you understand?
I say this because, so, you know, the topic is, okay, for the sake of the topic, I'm just challenging the question because I feel like, that you know, it's flawed in itself. But for the sake of the topic that we're bringing
flooding up... Flooding itself, explain how you mean it.
Because I feel like, it should be a case of, if you're talking about, because it's on the premise that women shouldn't put things in their name, whereas I'm speaking about this, you know, because you said it's stemming from mm-hmm. a long-standing conversation. Whereas it's well known that men do buy properties in their name without their wives against
well known how from
because it's like, you know, for example, the women that, you know, I saw some of the comments is that, okay, so husband's family are able to come and take the property away from the wife, because a lot of the time it's, you know, maybe they haven't done due diligence and put it in them and their wife's name. Because, you know, as much as, yes, traditional things can happen, but if legally it belongs to the wife, how are they able to take it away?
So, like you said, now they've not done due diligence and mm-hmm. put it in them and the wife's name.
Yeah.
Probably that husband already had the property before they got married.
Okay.
And, like...
Well, what if they didn't?
Wait now. Okay. No.
Okay.
What, like, whatever property you buy when you are married to somebody is supposed to be in both of your names. Do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
And that is why we're having this. And that is why the question is, like, should a lady... So what I would have just expected was, okay, in the course of your defense and everything, mm-hmm. you can bring it up that, okay, is the man too? And this question is not coming from the assumption that, oh, the man is supposed to buy a property by himself, the lady is not supposed to buy a property mm-hmm. by himself. You can as well now bring up another topic that, okay, is a man allowed? But this is coming from already things that already, even that day, I was shocked at the way ladies were coming. Do you understand?
Because, yeah.
This is already coming from
mm-hmm.
the assumptions now that, okay, lady, watch out for yourself as, mm-hmm. as you are going into this marriage.
Mm-hmm.
Like, make sure, okay, and that is where my own question is coming from, that, okay, should there be, like, are you supposed to enter a marriage with an escape plan? Do
okay.
you understand?
Yeah.
Now, back to what I'm saying about mm-hmm. most men, like, most times, maybe... Most times when a lady marry, maybe the man is already successful before the lady married the man. So he already calmed down, he already
mm-hmm.
has a house and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, they are just in love and it just doesn't come up. It's not a question of, oh, okay, this is my property, don't touch. You get, because when you were already one, you are in my house and everything, but like you said, due diligence, it never came up that, okay, let's change this to our name. It's not
mm-hmm.
that he bought it in his name when they were already together and everything.
Right, okay.
And I even said it then that
yeah.
In my own argument that, oh yeah, let's even assume that, okay, the lady got properties before she got married to the man and everything.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, you can leave those properties in your name.
Mm-hmm.
You get, because, okay, it's whatever you got. But whatever you buy within the course of the wedding, like, the way I see it, like, once you are married, whatever work you are doing, whatever income you are getting, yeah, keep your income and all that.
Mm-hmm.
But if you are buying stuff, buy in both of your names.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people are saying, so how will I, all the things I've worked for in my life, how will I give it to a man? Buying in both your names is
mm-hmm.
not giving to a man.
Mm-hmm.
I just feel like marriage is supposed to be a union, it's supposed to be coming together as one and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And if you are going into a marriage already with a plan of an escape plan, that means you already have a mindset that, okay, something is going to go wrong, and
mm-hmm.
that means you are not there, like, fully. And
mm-hmm.
and it should go both ways and everything. Yeah, the man should be there fully, the woman should be there fully and everything.
Mm-hmm.
But I asked the question, okay, should the woman, okay, I made the woman the subject of the matter because, yeah, these things have been coming up a lot. And in as much as, yeah, they are happening, yeah, you hear cases of a man got married and he went to marry somebody else later, I left the woman, or you get, a lot of all those things are coming. And women are like, okay, yeah, getting scared and everything, yeah, you understand? So that is where my question is coming from, that, okay, whether it happens or not, or based on everything that's happening, so is it right to enter a marriage with an escape plan, which is, okay, so are you supposed to buy properties in your own name? Do you understand?
Yeah.
Considering that you are married to someone else.
Okay. I say that you can't necessarily say it is an escape plan. Do you understand? Like, some people, some people's mindset are different. You know, again, with people's marriages are different. Marriages, there's no black, it's not black and white kind of thing. There's, you know, like, this is a particularly gray area. So I feel like, you know, we can't make the assumption that they're buying the property in their name as an escape route. But some women, especially nowadays, because of what's happened before, maybe because of what they've seen, what happened to parents, or perhaps people that they know, older women, they've been through a lot. And they don't want to be in a place where they don't have anything for themselves. Just like, you know, like you said, if a man is successful, and, you know, it's, you know, we see this successful man, you see that. Well, if a woman is successful, blah, blah, blah. But if a woman is successful, it's almost attributed to the man, right? So sometimes women just want to have, like, some. I'm not saying that it's wrong.
But that was then. The woman's success is attributed to her nowadays.
You're still a small minority. You and those men that believe that are still a small minority. We can't assume that Nigeria has changed that much. It hasn't moved forward that much. And, you know, it's still a case of, and I'm talking about people in our age bracket as well. They still consider whatever success that the woman has is based on the man. And some women, they just want to have that, you know, okay, I did this, you know, I was able to accomplish this. Whereas I feel like it should be a thing of a joint, whatever you do, like, you know, like when divorces happen, celebrity divorces happen, usually, so I was saying that usually, like, when I've seen in celebrity divorces, when they're splitting things down the middle, whatever has been acquired during the marriage is split down the middle, mm-hmm. It's half-half, because mm-hmm. they say that whatever, even if the person wasn't actively physically involved in it, the support of the other person is considered as contribution towards whatever has been, whatever asset that they have.
So if a woman or a man, mm-hmm. but now because we're talking about woman, so if a woman was a very, very successful one, mm-hmm. the most successful, mm-hmm. and they ended up divorcing and they split halfway, so it's seen as a woman's loss, Abby?
Is that a
loss?
Yeah.
So with that, she's supposed to now, a woman is not supposed to secure herself when she's entering a marriage.
No, I don't believe that.
That was my question.
You know, I believe that, you know, obviously you have, it's important to be transparent. The most, I think marriage is the most exposing relationship you can ever have, you know, down to physically, as well as emotionally and spiritually. You literally have to bear all. After God, marriage is like, it's that you have to be that vulnerable.
If you then
feel like you need to start hiding things or doing things on your own, aside from your spouse, then maybe then there's a deeper problem, then there's a deeper issue than that is.
Because a lot of women that they were like, of course I will buy properties for myself, like
married women.
Yeah, a lot, like online and everything, even single ladies that before they get married and everything. And the everything was based around so that what will not happen to me and my children, you know, those kind of things, you get. And I see it from the angle that, okay, God will protect all of us and everything, but the angle of death and everything, let's say, okay, you lose your husband, God forbid, or anything. Whatever you buy joint, like, you can't be taken off it, because it's buying, the only difference between buying joint and buying personal is personal, and joint is joint. I don't know how else to put it, but it's still your property. Do you understand? But you are buying it in both your names, is just making it a union thing and everything. And it can be done, you can even do it that, okay, if one of these parties are now absent, like if anything happens, the other person gets it. Do you understand? Mm-hmm. I feel it is still secure and everything. You understand? I feel like if you are going into a relationship and you already have that mindset that, okay, I should watch out for myself, then maybe you should not go into it. Do you understand?
And I also feel like, you know, like you were, again, like I said, that you're a small minority, whereas, you know, like back in the day, they used to say to men about men that they shouldn't let their wife know how much they're
That came up too.
You know, and I think that's something that still happens.
I feel a lot of men still,
So I can understand why the women will feel like, oh, you know, if they can do that, so then I can protect what I have, which is not right. I think that, you know, again, if you're married, you need to be vulnerable in every area. And financially is so important because you need to know what is coming in and what's going out. Even if it's the other person that has made it and you're not intending on spending it, it's still important for you to know what you have and what you don't have. And as a woman as well, you can't just leave it up to the man to, you know, oh, he's sorting out the finances, whatever, that, you know, that's fine. We have to be clued up. We have to make sure that we have an understanding of what is coming. If you don't have an understanding, get some understanding. Because it says, "Is wisdom profiteth the wise." Like, it's important for us to be wise in terms
wisdom
of...
Wisdom did what?
Profiteth the wise, no?
Profit what?
Profits the wise.
Okay, but what is the profiteth the wise?
Profiteth.
Okay, profiteth.
Profiteth.
T-E-T-H.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think that's right.
It's profitable to die. Okay, profiteth the wise.
Profiteth. I don't know.
Don't speak our English. Just speak in James English.
To the wise. Wisdom is profitable to the wise. But anyway, I'm just like, best I win. But I feel like it's important that we can't just sit back and say, okay, he's dealing with that. We should be involved in every aspect of our marriage and of our relationships. And if, say, the husband is blocking that, then that's a deeper conversation. The answer isn't let me just protect myself. The answer is, we need to deal with this head on. We need to sort this out because it's our money. It's our, you know, it's our marriage. It belongs to us together. So... Yeah.
Yeah. Anyways, I don't feel anybody should buy properties for themselves in marriage.
No.
Like, a woman should not buy property in her name. She should buy in both their names.
Mm-hmm.
It's showing sign of
division.
When you buy in both your names, showing sign of submission. Now, talking about submission, should be both ways. The husband himself should submit in terms of that. Like, you understand? Like, because the only way a man would want to buy another property is probably he's buying for another babe outside. You understand? And that doesn't make sense. And that is something a lot of women to also try to protect themselves from and everything. It's actually very, neither here nor there conversation, very, very sensitive conversation
here.
But my angles are, I feel all of us should come in as we are. You get, like, just come into the relationship. That's why I also don't believe in prenup.
Yeah, I don't believe in that. It's you're like, planning to break up.
Do you understand? Yeah. Like, you... What does prenup work like? Okay, if divorce happens, this person does not get anything.
Yeah, basically.
So I don't.
Like, you have stipulated. You have various stipulations. Like, this, you know, it will be based on this. This, you get this, and based
and
on this.
And that's also the exact same reason why I don't believe anybody should buy properties in their name, because you're already creating insecurity for the other party. You understand? For you to have a prenup that, okay, if divorce comes, you are not going with anything. That means maybe there's 1% or 2% a part of your mind that is saying that, okay, yeah, maybe something can go wrong later. Meanwhile, I believe marriage and wedding should be 100% all the way. Do you understand?
Absolutely.
That's why they say that for better or for worse. That's why I believe personally. I think everybody should go in 100%. But, you know, based on a lot of things that are on 100%.
100.
But this is a young man, small guy, not married for too long. I'm just saying the way I just feel. So what do you guys feel about it, you know? How do you feel about it? And like the way my wife just attacked me from the beginning of this thing, it's not like because you were coming like
it
just about the women.
No, I wasn't.
But I was coming from a premise.
It wasn't your question for you to feel attacked from. I said that it was the question. I said the question that I felt like it was flawed in.
But that question is not like a standard question in the sense that it's not. The only question that should be asked,
of course,
as far as it's but it's the way I chose to ask the question for this episode.
I understand that, but then at the same time, for me, is that we can't be ignorant of this.
Because, for example,
we can't be ignorant of the society that we're in. That for the most part, women are considered a second class citizen in Nigeria. That's how it is. Unfortunately, not everybody thinks like you do, and that's why I said that I had to highlight the fact that the question is already flawed from the beginning. Not that, you know, I don't agree with the line of questioning. I'm just saying it's flawed that, you know, we don't necessarily explore the man side of things, because there's an expectation that the man is, why can't the same expectation be there for the woman?
That's what do you people shall understand now? My question is let's imagine this is a show. So that was the topic for today. So we could as well go next week and be like, should a man, and there are different conversations entirely. Do you understand? Because, like, a woman buying property in her name, the most times the intention is different and the conversation is totally different to a man buying properties in his name. Mm-hmm. But they are like it, I feel they are both wrong. Do you understand? Mm. But you get what I'm trying to say. For example, a man could be buying property in his name because he feels his wife has no right to his, I'm the man anyways, you understand? And I feel it's wrong. You get like that's why I feel it like a lot of times if a man acts that way because it's like, okay, yeah, I'm the man, I'm the provider, you get, I'm cuckoo giving you anyway, so you don't have a right to this. So it comes from pride most times. Mm. Meanwhile, women, yes, some women's own too can also come from, okay, yeah, now me they make them, but a lot of times women's own is coming from trying to be secure or insecurity, you get. So do you get what I'm trying to say?
That's what
you
get.
Because Abdul with a call. Because naturally, I feel okay, I don't want to stereotype, but from what I've from a bit of my exposure, so not exposure, from my own reasoning so far, although I think a lot of things are changing nowadays, but naturally I feel women normally are prone to be more faithful, but because of whatever experience or whatever things might have slapped them, it might push them back and make them to want to be secure. Mm-hmm. And that is why I was coming from the angle of women today, that okay, is it right for you to step into something when you feel like, okay, you need to secure yourself? Because I feel whatever you want to step into, you should have 100% security. You understand? You get what I'm trying to say?
Yes, and I understand that.
Yeah.
But sometimes some of the women are coming from, okay, maybe they were feeling secure and then something happened that changed that. So again, like, you know, that's why I still maintain that it's a very gray area. Like, this is my stance on it, whereas this is our stance on it. We agree that, you know, it should be for both. But, you know, people do things for their own reason. And there's no criticism or judgment towards that. It's just, you know, we just stand for unity within marriage, regardless of what you're going through. It's hard. Exactly. You know, it's very, very difficult.
It's not beans to say.
It's not.
I think we should just conclude it by saying there's no conclusion to this topic.
Basically.
Like, do you understand? We can't even boldly say, although that's what we believe.
Yeah.
Like, that's
for
what
ourselves.
We, do you understand?
Yeah.
Like, whatever I will buy, her name has to be there. Whatever, it's even for both of us, because she's suffering with me. So even if I'm making more money, the money is coming as a result of our prayers and also some other stuff as she's suffering. Because some things she's not making in money, she's replenishing in a lot of other ways. Mm. She's building my home. Like, in this house, like, holding this house together, she's doing like 70%. Do you understand? Yeah. Do you understand? So that is what we believe, but that we are not making it a standard. We hope it can be a standard, though. You get, but we want to hear from you. You understand, based on your experience and everything. So what do you think?
Yeah.
So thank you very much. It's been amazing today. We have some amazing random moments. Which one are we putting up today? I'm trying to remember.
So the one with Fermi giving me a birthday cake.
No, there was one. There was a funnier one.
My birthday's coming up. But
no, that one that she was crying. And then she stopped, like you were just looking at that. Okay. So just random moment for today. OMGs, OMGs.
Finish crying.
Okay.
This is my ice cream, it's finished. You done crying? You wipe your eyes now. Here's some tissue. I hate some tissue. Would you like some tissue? To wipe your tears? Here you go. Here, to wipe your eyes. No more crying. All done. Don't put it in your mouth. Don't put it in your bowl. Put the tissue on the table, thank you. Thank you. You put the tissue on the table. Bury me. Give it to mummy. I'll just take that. Thank you. There's crying.
Yeah, that was funny, Abby. These children are wise. They know what they are doing. Anyways, thank you very much. See you guys on this one is. So see you. Now we are skeptical about Wednesday. This is Monday.
Yeah,
but we are skeptical about Wednesday. So we'll still do for this Wednesday. Fair on me. That's me and her singing. But if the engagement is not as encouraging, we might just scrap it and just be doing Mondays and Fridays, which is talk and game day. But thank you very much. Make sure you subscribe and make sure you turn on the notifications button. Because now we have like, it's over 5,000 subscribers, but each time we post videos, we still get like maybe 2,000, 3,000 views. And we are hoping that our subscriber base will be equivalent with our views so that we know that this number of people are the number of people watching.
Yeah,
so absolutely. Please help us. Just turn on that bell so that you know whenever we post videos
absolutely.
And you watch them. We love you. Thank you very much.
Thank you guys for watching. And again, if there's any videos that you want us to do,
oh yeah, talk to us. Come here, I'm let you watch. Oh yeah.
And again, if there are any videos that you want us
topics
to do,
you want us to talk about, drop them in the comments.
And also follow us on our Instagram at the OMG.
Yeah, it's there already. And whatever games you want us to play, please drop a comment. We love you. Bye.
Bye.
Abdul!